As light goes into your eye, it first goes through your cornea, the protective outer surface of the eye, and then it hits your iris, which is the colored part of your eye. The lens focuses the image to the back of the retina, and then the retina tissue is where the photoreceptor layers are to detect the light impulses and send them through the optic nerve back to the brain. Our eyes are unique and different, and everybody has a unique iris coloration, like a fingerprint on their eye, and so our perception is unique. Our eyes allow us to see the good in the world.
It turns out that recognizing things is a really tough computational problem, and it costs a lot of neurons to do it. So, do we see goodness? When we're judging goodness, I think typically that's a beauty judgment. Spanish philosopher George Santayana defined beauty as the pleasure we attribute to the object. These individual differences in what we find beautiful are a very powerful and common feature of our lives. And this can apply in quite abstract ways. And it's not just literally what the motion is, but what it signifies.
Okay, come forward. Squint the eyes a little bit. Good. The most beautiful thing that you see in a person is the beauty in their eyes. You can see their past, their presence, and where they are right at this moment through the eyes. So I did the first 2 years of my modeling career, you know, totally in a blur because I wasn't seeing well. And when I got my contacts and glasses, I mean, the whole world just opened up. It was just like amazing. I'm like, this is the world. This is what I've been missing.
Eyes are critical in order to see the world and perceive the good in the world, and so our perception is unique and allows us to be beautiful in our own way, as well as experience the beautiful colors in the world around us.
When you see good deeds, you just have that compassion feeling in your eyes, and there's a warmth and a feeling that overtakes you. It's great.